Okay, this is part three of Yay and Call Me Senorita Estúpida, because my mom called at the end of the last video, so it stopped it automatically, yay. But anyway, she was still sounding out of her mind, out of her mind, out of her freaking mind. But anyway, okay. So, oh my god, look at fruit flies. I have some pears that my aunt gave me, and I put them in a cardboard box to let them ripen because I don't have any paper bags, and I'm getting cold. 75 degrees in here, but I'm getting cold. Okay, so I put them in the cardboard box. She gave me about five pairs. So, I ate three of them. And, they were really juicy after they had ripened. And so I had let the other two in there to continue to ripen, but then whatever, I probably ate some pasta or something, and I just didn't feel like eating pears, so they have rotted, probably not completely, but inside the box, so we have fruit flies, yay. And so yeah. Okay. I don't want ginger. I really wanted some onions, but since he ain't been back to his farm in quite a while, I'll just take what I can get. Insane in the membrane. Insane in the brain. Insane in the membrane. I guess I could go see who made that song. That's my BFF and her 25-year-old son who is shipping off in the army. You know what's funny is that, not funny, haha, but funny, like coincidence, ironic, or whatever. Okay, it is in Cypress Hill. Anyway, my best friend's oldest son is named Nicholas. Her youngest son is named Christopher. And Evan, his middle name is Christopher. I kind of named him Christopher, in tribute, I guess, to Angela's Christopher. But I also, when my mom was pregnant, had I been a boy, she would have named me Christopher, and then all three of her children would have had C names. But I wasn't a boy, thank God. So I got to be named Angelica, and no one knows how to pronounce it. I mean, seriously, I'm Angelica, Angelica, whatever, just not Angelica. Okay, so I was named Angelica because when she was pregnant with me, she was in Ger well, we were all in Germany. And she wanted a different name, not, an American sounding name. So yeah, I've always been the only Angelica in every class I've gone to, and since my dad was in the army, We moved every 4 freaking years. And that's why I let people call me Angie, A-N-G-Y, because I just got tired of every first day of school or whenever I moved to the place, Angelica, Anglica, Angelica, what is this? So I'm like, just call me Angie. Because, you know, when you're in school, you just want to fit in with everybody. And I didn't want to stick out with my crazy name. And it wasn't until I went to college and after I dropped out of University of Alabama, I went to, I guess it's a technical school. So my professors there, I went there for accounting. And so my professors there called me Angelica, and I'm like, you know what, I like my name. Because I had already realized that by that time I really didn't like people in general. So, I'm like, I like my name, because I can pretend that it's not me. If someone's calling my name and they're saying Angelica or Angelica or whatever, I could just be like, oh, I didn't hear you, because my name's Angelica, so I didn't think you were talking to me, because if you knew me, you would know my name is not Angelica. Right? You feel me? See what I'm saying? That's the kind of bitch I am. Anyway, after I talked to my mama, I tried to find my Epsom salt, and I can't. So, damn. And I'm going to have to get on the goddamn floor and look under the bed and under the futon. Oh, hell, it might be in the kitchen in the pantry. I don't know, but I know I got to shit. I mean, I feel like I got to shit, but it ain't, you know, coming out, even though I'm trying everything I can do. Because, like, one of the things I've noticed is that if I sit on the edge of my bed and put my knees up on the box spring and push like I'm trying to fart, then it, you know, gets me turtling. And then I can go ahead and, shit. But, I tried to do that yesterday and this morning and whatnot, and it was not working for me. And then I realized, oh yeah, cause you're a damn drug addict, you're constipated. I think Evan's about to come in the house, maybe. I heard some doors shut. Yep, here he comes. So, I reckon I will talk to you later. Say hi, baby.
Hi, baby.